Today I'm in stunning West Yorkshire, trying to find a new place for Kat and Simon, who want to get a bit more freedom in their lives by waving goodbye to their massive monthly bills and moving to a new home.
The reason we've decided to go mortgage-free is for better, I think, life security. So you're not just working to pay bills anymore, you're freeing up money to do more of the fun stuff, like go travelling, have more time with the kids and, you know, just enjoy life, so we're not just paying bills.
Kat and Simon are keen to find a project house they can do up and make their forever home. And while they love the idea of the first house...
It's a superb open space, isn't it?
Isn't it amazing? Yeah.
The proximity to a busy road and the lack of outside space were a definite stumbling block.
The road is just really noisy.
It is a busy road, yeah.
So I'm taking them to see a house that's less challenging but still full of promise. The second option I'm going to show Kat and Simon is in Honley, 19 miles from the first house in Denholm. Honley is a small village with a population of just under 7,000, but it boasts three schools for Simon and Kat's kids and is a decent commute for Simon by car, or a bit longer by bus or rail.
So this is the house that I'm going to be showing you. It's called the Station House because it was the former station master's home. Initial impressions from the outside.
The house looks nice, I'm just not feeling the location right now. I know it's very convenient, it's a little bit too convenient.
It's not a busy line, but yes, it is there. Simon, what are you thinking?
Yeah, the house looks quite quaint, it looks nice, it looks well kept as well.
I think that it needs somebody with vision to make it bigger and better, if that makes sense.
Yeah.
Let's get inside.
Inside, the house has a kitchen, lounge, dining room and conservatory downstairs. Upstairs are three decent bedrooms and a family bathroom. While in the basement is another living room, perfect for Kat's office. It's priced at £285,000.
Into the kitchen, which is quite unusual.
Yeah, L-shaped.
Yes. So that was the original wall of the house. What are you thinking walking through the door?
I'm sure the rest of the house has plenty of potential. As it stands at the moment, walking straight in onto a brick wall. You couldn't see your children, you know, if you're trying to make something to eat, it's nice to see the kids playing and see what they're doing.
Yeah, my theory is that this has to come out and this is turned into a very kind of elaborate storeroom, boot room, utility room.
Cloak room of some sort.
Yeah. What are you thinking, Simon?
I think I need to see the rest of the space to see what's achievable. Yeah. If that's the old external wall, you're certainly not going to be able to take that down.
You can make a nice feature out of this nice brick wall. I think it's got potential, but it's not a kitchen, is it?
No.
I can see why Amanda's brought us here. Yeah. It's got quite a bit of scope to be quite an interesting family home. It's nowhere near there at the moment, but it is easily fixable.
It's definitely not a forever home, but whether it's a stepping stone towards something that could be our forever home. So, yeah, there is scope, but I think we really need to think about this one.
So they haven't discounted this house, but it's not given them the, wow, we want to move in. I want to show them that now. I want to show them something that will give them the lifestyle that they're looking for. I'm quite excited to show you this house because I think it's got loads of potential. This is the house that I want you to see. What's going through your minds?
Well, I've learnt from where we live now that to look beyond the skin of things.
Exactly.
I'm just looking at the fields.
I mean, quiet, it's peaceful, there's good schools, there's open countryside.
Yeah, two car parking places.
Two spaces, four bedrooms. Yep. Detached garage, which is your project, Simon.
Yeah, I love that wisteria.
Inside, the house has a breakfast diner, a conservatory and decent-sized living room. Upstairs, there are four bedrooms with a master that boasts not just an ensuite, but a balcony with amazing views. And there's also space for Kat to have her office. Outside is one of the best views in the whole country. Add to the mix of space for the kids and the cats, and what's not to like? Price, £300,000.
Yeah.
Look at the views.
That's a nice view.
Even out the back.
Look, yeah. Yeah, that's a good view.
What are you thinking?
Quite taken aback, actually. by this. It's got a lot more than I think we were expecting.
It's interesting, isn't it? It is that classic, don't judge a book by its cover. Yeah. What would you do in here, then?
I think long-term, I'd probably look at making this an open living sort of area.
Possibly. Ceiling to floor windows, maybe wrap around a bit if you could.
You need to frame that view. Yeah. Is what it needs.
That window doesn't do it justice, no. I don't think. Yeah.
So this is top whack of your budget. It's on at 300,000.
Okay.
It goes to sealed bids tonight.
Ah, all right. Okay.
I know. There's already been two offers around the asking price. So my thinking is if you like it, you'd have to go in at full asking price, possibly a smidge over. But you'd be mortgage free. Well, there's a lot to think about. Do you want to have a look at the garden?
Yeah.
Let's go through the playroom to the garden. Come on out to your garden. It's so quiet.
Yeah.
What about the size of the garden?
It's a good size, yeah. I think that's just right, really.
It's just bigger than it looks as well.
Yeah,
because
it is.
You've got this patch here, haven't you? And you've got this here.
Yeah. Lots of ideas.
There's a lot of potential. It does, yeah.
You look totally different with this one than you have done with the other two. What is it?
I suppose I'm feeling a bit emotional. I think you've sort of hit a nerve a bit, actually. A good one.
It's my office.
Yeah. Must all be about the view in here.
Yeah.
That's a lovely view, isn't it? Yeah.
It's the office, so it is a small room.
Tiny, but it's an office. Yeah.
Is there room in there for another room? That could be my studio.
Yeah, it's got enough height. You'd have to redo all the trusses, but I mean, you do anyway.
Right, OK, so this is my new office.
I'm a little bit excited. Not as excited as Kat and Simon, but I am quite excited because I think that they really like this house. And you know what? I think that it would be the perfect house for them. They could move into it straight away. They could live, they could breathe, they could relax, but they could do stuff to really make it their own.
This must be their master suite.
Oh, look at this.
Look at the view. Imagine waking up to that.
It'd look lovely.
Get a coffee machine in here and just can sit on the balcony.
So we would sit up here, have a little drinky, looking at the view.
It's beautiful, isn't it?
Yeah, quite gobsmacked, actually. Caught me, this one.
It's definitely a box ticker. It left us with a bit of a decision to make, I think.
Yeah.
So they're sold on the house, but with the deadline for sealed bids at the end of today, will they be able to commit to an offer in time?
Your face, Kat, was so different outside that house to any of the others. What was it about it?
Don't know where to start, really.
The wisteria?
Yeah, the wisteria, the purple wisteria. And it was just countryside, rolling countryside. Made me sort of feel a bit homesick, but then thought, yes, this could really work, and it had so much potential.
I think it's helped to reaffirm that location's more important than architecture.
Isn't that interesting?
Yeah, it had something the others didn't.
It had a different lifestyle, I think.
A different feel to it. Mm-hmm. It was calming.
Yeah.
So do you think now, then, that it's the location and the vibe of it more than the actual bricks and mortar?
Yes.
Yeah.
Definitely.
That's interesting.
Mm-hmm.
So when we were leaving that one, I said to you, it's going to go to last and final bids now. Where are you at?
Ultimately, we just haven't got the time to satisfy our own
research schools,
requirements, I guess.
Find out if there's a local nursery, enough things to do for the kids.
Just want to know as much as we can about the area.
Fine.
And we're just not going to be able to do that in an hour.
No, and I totally get that. And I also get that this needs to be right. You cannot just do this on a toss of a coin and just go, let's go for that one. But I guess the important question is have I done enough to convince you that it is possible to go mortgage-free?
Yeah, definitely.
It's shown us some areas where you can get an awful lot of value for money.
Absolutely.